Hello, no movie reviews today. I just wanted to make this very quick video. It's about the gender critical mob. They used to be called TERFs, which apparently is a slur now. Don't know why, it was a very accurate description. But now they're called, they call themselves gender critical. Gender critical is basically a new form of man-hating, you know? Anyway, I'll explain, right? Have you ever heard somebody make an argument, right? And as they're making the argument, you kind of go, you know, I see what you mean. That makes perfect sense. And then just at the end of the argument, they then say something, and it makes you go, whoa, what the fuck? I don't agree with that. That's my issue with these gender critical people, right? I mean, I've made a video before about my whole views on the trans women thing and all that. I think it's fucking hilarious, right? Because feminists are evil, right? They've been evil for decades, and this is now their comeuppance. They brought this on themselves, and it was fucking hilarious. So I love it. I just love it, right? It's really great. But there's the argument they make. They try to get you on side. I'll give you an example of the argument, right? So let's say it goes like this, right? It goes like this. My argument is Christians shouldn't pray in a mosque because Christians have already got their own place of worship, and the mosque is for the Muslims. The same the other way around. Muslims shouldn't be praying in the church, because the church is for the Christians and they've already got their own place of worship. So these people should stick to their own places of worship, right? Now you hear me make that argument, right? And you're nodding along and you go, you know what? That makes sense. You know, church for the Christians, mosque for the Muslims. That makes sense. Can't see anything wrong with that. Brilliant. I agree with you, but I'm not finished my argument yet, because right at the end of the argument, I then have to throw in the part about, you know, the reason Christians shouldn't be in the mosque is because they'll rape the kids in there, and the reason the Muslims shouldn't be in the church is because they'll blow it up. Now, do you see how you were agreeing with me all that way until the end, where I fucked up the whole argument by being hateful? Do you see how I didn't have to be hateful to make my point? You got the point, you agreed with it, makes sense. There was no hatred there until the very end. I decided to shit on either Christians or Muslims, whatever, right? That's what these people do, right? They cannot help themselves when it comes to shitting on men. The reason they're gender critical is because they hate men, right? And I'll explain what happened earlier in the week with an argument I had with somebody on Twitter, right? So predictable. But then I'll show you a little video of Posey Parker. I can't remember her real name. Kelly something. Oh God, can't remember it. Anyway, you'll know her when you see her. Now, because I've been watching a lot of these videos where they're talking about, you know, should trans women be allowed in female prisons? Should they be allowed in female changing rooms and female bathrooms, right? And my view is that no, of course they shouldn't be, because they are male. They were born male, stick to the male spaces. Were you born female? Stick to the female spaces, right? I'm not hating anybody. You know, I'm not saying anything bad about that. I'm just saying, if you were born male, you stick to the male spaces. You go to the male prison. If you're born female, you go to the female prison. And you don't need to commit a crime, by the way. If you're born female, you definitely just go to prison. And anyway, you go to the female prison, right? Now, I'm not hating on anybody there. Like, that's what I think. I think that's the way it should go, right? So this, but they, because they can't help shitting on men, right? And remember, they view trans women as men, which is fine. So do I, right? So this woman, this post on Twitter the other day, and they were saying, you know, you need to keep these trans women out of women's prisons, right? And I'm thinking, wait a minute, why again? It's because they're male, right? No, it's not because they're male. No, apparently that's not the reason. The reason you must keep trans women out of prison is because trans women are a danger to the women in the prison, because apparently women in prison are vulnerable. That's right, they said vulnerable. Do you know what you have to do to get into prison as a woman? You have to not be vulnerable. That's a fucking start. Anyway, so then the logic doesn't work for me. If they just said they shouldn't be in there because they're not female, fine, I agree with that. But when you say it's because they're a danger, it's then like, wait, what do you mean they're a danger? How are they a danger again? Well, they might sexually abuse the women. Right, hang on. Aren't there already women in there that are in there for sexual abuse? And aren't the women in there at risk from them? I mean, it doesn't make any sense, right? Oh no, but they're violent and they might hurt the women that's in there. Right, okay, so this is the exchange I had with this fucking idiot the other day. So this idiot made this point that trans women, men, they can go into women's prison and be a risk to the women because they're violent. So I asked a simple question that they could not answer, even though it's a yes or no question, right? I simply asked the question, are the women in prison safe from the violent women in prison, right? And they would not answer this fucking very simple question, and I must have asked this question about a dozen fucking times, because I don't sway from the topic when these idiots come at me, right? So when I asked the question at first it was like, oh, that's irrelevant, and no, are they safe from the violent women in prison? You just hate women. Are they safe from the violent women in prison? I just kept asking it. They tried their best. I think I was called incel. I get called incel that much, I forget. I think they called me an incel. They said I hate women. All this crap, but they just would not answer this question. So I even posted a screenshot of it, and I even said on Twitter, this person will block me before they answer this question, because they can't answer it. And I was right, they blocked me because without answering the question. The reason they wouldn't answer the question is because whatever answer they gave exposed them for being a man hater. So if they said, yes, right, yes, the women in prison are safe from the violent women in there, then I would have to always ask the question, so why wouldn't they be safe from the violent man then? Which would expose them for being a man hater, because they hate men and they see them as these rapist, violent beasts, you know? And if they said no, they wouldn't be safe, I said, well, why does it concern you then that there's a man in there that makes them unsafe? They're unsafe anyway, right? So they couldn't answer the question, so they had to block me. And this is my problem with these people, right? Because they could simply say they shouldn't be in the prison because they are male and they should be in the male prison. And that's what I was talking about that argument. Okay, that makes sense. Okay, fair enough. I can see your point. But then when they finish the point by saying the men shouldn't be in the women's prison because they're violent rapists, then you're like, whoa, hang on, sorry, what? What again? What the fuck are you talking about? What do you mean they're violent rapists? I mean, well, so men are just violent rapists then, and that's why they shouldn't be. Why, you could have just stuck to the point and said, no, it's because they're male. That's why. You don't have to shit on men. I know you're a feminist, and you can't help yourself, but you have to try to control that if you're trying to get us on your side. Because, as I say, I would be on your side, but because of the man hate, I'm just put off this. And the thing's astonishing as well, is that, like, when you look at left and right, people on the left, they're all about the trans community. Oh, they love that. They love to say a trans woman is a woman. They fucking love that shit, right? And the people on the right tend to be like, no, they're men, right? Fine. But yet, see when they start shitting on men, the feminists, or sorry, the gender critical people, when they start shitting on men, people on the right, They then go, yes, I see your point, yes, men are fucking rapists, aren't they? Men are violent, aren't they? It's like, what the fuck are you doing? What the fuck are you, what kind of argument are you making here? They should make it so simple. If you're born male, you stick to male spaces. If you're born female, you stick to female spaces. That's it, that's simple. There is no need to shit on men and women, but I'm going to show you this video, and, excuse me, I'm going to show you this clip, I should say. I watched the video recently, so I'll be able to check my history, and I'll post a link to the full video so you can check for yourself, right? Because I'm just going to show you a clip that I posted on Twitter, right, with this video. It's honestly, it's, see if you can spot the fucking blatant, glaring double standard coming from Posey Parker, right? Sorry, I forget her name. It's, her name might be actually on there. Just watch this. I've already written it down, but let's just, so I've given it away. I've given it away, haven't it, by writing it by writing it down, doesn't matter. Just listen to this gibberish.
Well, for a start, it's a very small number, and no, I don't think any man can ever become a woman at all. I'm just very clear on that. But most men have
trans men with a cervix. Are you saying that they have to use female toilets as well?
Right. So she's saying she doesn't believe a man can become a woman. I absolutely agree with that. Right. So he then says, "Hang on, what about a man with a cervix, in other words, a trans man, right? Should she have to use the..." Just got a message there. Okay. Right, okay. Sorry about that. Aye, so he's just asked her there, should the trans man have to use the women's bathroom then? Because, you know, if the trans woman has to use the man's bathroom, fair enough. Should the trans man have to use the women's bathroom, right? And what does she say?
No, I'm saying that women are more vulnerable, and therefore women have the right to have female-only space. If some women identify as men and want...
So, women have the right to a female-only space, but men don't. Why was that again? What was the reason again? Oh, because women are vulnerable. Hang on. If women are vulnerable, should we, like, treat them completely differently then? Should they be allowed to vote if they're vulnerable? I mean, where does this vulnerability lie? Is it in their minds? Are they vulnerable in their minds? Are they stupid? Where are they vulnerable? You know, they just play this card. Oh no, women are more vulnerable. Boom, there you go, done. End of story. That means we can have all the double standards we want because we've declared women to be vulnerable. What? Fucking crap.
Want to use men's spaces? That's entirely up to them. They don't have...
See, if a woman identifying as a man wants to use a male space, that's entirely up to them, but the trans women shouldn't be in women's spaces. But what the fuck? What? How can you be so fucking hypocritical on this? What the fuck? God.
Pose a threat to those men.
So you see what I mean? Because men, they pose a threat to women. But women, no, they don't pose a threat to men. Not at all. Women are never violent at all. Never violent. No. Never violent. And they certainly never falsely accuse anyone of rape. So it's not like they're going to go into prison or into a man's changing room and accuse them of rape. No, that would never happen. Don't be silly. Women are pure, angelic, you know.
That's double standards, isn't it?
Yes.
No, it's talking about the fact...
No. It is literally double standards. You can't say no. It is double standards.
There are 12,000 sexual predators in male prisons.
Sorry, what's that got to do with it again? There are 12,000 sexual predators in male prisons. Right? What's your point again? Why does that mean trans women can't go into the... What? I don't understand. Why did you bring that up? Oh, that's right. You brought it up because you had to shit on men. I keep forgetting. We're talking about trans women here, by the way, but let's shit on men anyway. Right, okay. Okay.
And the whole population of females in prison is 3,000.
Right, that's an interesting thing because what I'm told, this is what I'm told, right, if more black people go to prison than white people, that's because of racism. So if there are more men in prison than women, I wonder what that means. I wonder why that is. It can't be because they're more violent and they commit more crimes. It can't be that reason because it's not that reason for black people. So it must be a misandric system then, right? It must be the matriarchy. That must be the reason, right? Because why would that be the case? You know, I mean. She completely ignores the fact, by the way, I'm not going to claim that women commit more crimes. I'm not saying that. What I'm saying is that she's completely ignoring the fact that the justice system goes easy on women and they really need to be a criminal before they get sent to prison. You know what I mean? They usually get very light sentences or no sentences at all, which I've covered multiple times.
So we are talking about a popular... We know that men are much more likely to be violent and commit the sexual assault than women.
Hey, just like we know that Muslims are more likely to commit terror acts, right? Can we say that? Oh no, we can't say that because that would be Islamophobic. Or well, okay, so we know that black people are more likely to commit violent crime. We can say that, right? Oh no, we can't say that because that would be racist, right? Because those things are considered hateful. But yet when you say that, oh no, that's fine.
Let's not pretend that we don't know these things. Up until 5 minutes ago, that was something that was completely okay to say.
That's the thing. Up until 5 minutes ago, it was okay to say that, wasn't it, Posey? You know, for decades it was okay to say that, but now that trans women identify as women, now it's not okay to say that, is it? And you're having a bit of trouble with this. Just to be clear, it was never fucking okay to say that.
But actually men are more violent and they pose much more of a threat to women than women do to men.
Right, so men shouldn't be allowed near women, basically, because they pose a threat to women. Can anybody hear what's wrong with this argument? Do you see what I mean? You're trying to get me on your side, and that's how you do it. Don't you think? Have you ever heard of the expression, you get more flies with sugar than you do vinegar? You know? Maybe if you give a nicer message, more people would be on your side. I mean, the thing about this woman is, I actually agree with about like 90% of the stuff she says. But she has to throw that 10% in there that just makes me go, you know what, I'm not going to go along with this. Because you're just doing what feminists have been doing for decades, labelling men as rapists, labelling them as dangerous, and it's absolutely fucking despicable. So that's why I wanted to make this video, get it off my chest, and give me something to link these idiots to whenever I argue with them, so that I don't need to make 20 posts asking them the same fucking question that they can't answer. God. Anyway, I'll leave it there for now. Please let me know what you think. Why can't they just call them TERFs again? What was wrong with TERFs? Trans-exclusionary radical feminists. That is what they are. So what? What's wrong with that? Or whatever. Anyway, okay, the gender critical mob then. Whatever. Anyway, thank you very much for listening. Until next time.